DDR5 RAM, is it worth it for Star Citizen? We've done some testing, we're gonna see, let's get into it. So first of all, let's talk about how I've done this, the test setup. I've got some 3600 CL16 DDR4 RAM, and then I've also got this new DDR5 5600 CL36 RAM. Now, that also can run at 4800 CL40. So we've tested that as well, just to see how different it is. I've got motherboards, two Intel Alder Lake motherboards, one for DDR4 and one for DDR5. They're both the Gigabyte UD version. One is DDR4, one is DDR5. Apart from that, they're exactly the same. I've got the 12700KF in both systems, and I've got the 3080 from Nvidia in both. So the systems are identical, apart from the RAM. Motherboards are as identical as they can be. So in theory, these results should be pretty solid. As usual, I've done my 20 runs in Louisville, the best place to test for me, and you'll see the averages over here. So first of all, let's talk the DDR4, and you'll see here, here's our baseline, and that on its own doesn't mean anything. Actually, it's pretty good performance, as we see the 12700KF is an amazing Star Citizen CPU. But then here is the results for the 4800 megahertz DDR5, and you'll see that is not a great result, and yeah, that on its own doesn't give us much hope. But that's not with the XMP profile on, so we'll put the XMP profile on, and here are the full results, and we've got a whopping 52 FPS there. It's not a huge increase. It is higher, the average is higher, but interestingly, the 1% lows are lower for both results for the DDR5. And I think potentially that hints at the fact that the latency for DDR5 is currently not as good as it is for DDR4. So the memory bandwidth is up massively with DDR5, but the latency isn't quite as good. And so in some applications, some games, that can lead to good performance, and some applications and games that leads to worse performance in DDR4. In Star Citizen, our average is slightly up, but our lows are slightly down. So the question is this worth it? Well, I'll tell you that it cost me £370, which is about $500 or about €440. And so you tell me, is it worth it? I've got to say, it is not. The amount of performance is a 7% increase in performance for the top result there. That is silly, silly money for such a small increase in frames. And if you have to have the best, then DDR5, I think, with the average being higher, even though the 1% lows are lower, it is a better frame rate, but you really just should wait. This technology is really early on. What happens really with these things is that the technology matures, speeds get faster, latency comes down. And so really, in a few years, and also critically, price should come down. So in a few years' time, maybe a couple of years' time, the prices and the performance of DDR5 should be much better, and there should be an actual, real performance improvement versus DDR4. Yes, there's other games, and there might be other applications, there might be other reasons for doing it, but for Star Citizen itself, there really is no good reason to go to DDR5 right now at this point in early 2022. But it's your money, feel free to do what you like. But if you like this more technical look at Star Citizen, you can subscribe, you can like this video as well, you can now join the Discord and come and chat about Star Citizen technical stuff and group up there, as well as joining the channel and becoming a member and sending money straight to the bank. Amazing, because let me tell you, all of these parts cost me lots and lots of money, so feel free to help out in that way. But that's enough for this one. I'll see you soon. Bye.